is entertainment Las Vegas style. From the C2K showroom in the Venetian, it's the world's hottest magic show, starring Las Vegas' own Melinda, First Lady of Magic.
Ladies and gentlemen, the First Lady of Magic, Melinda.
Melinda, First Lady of Magic, here at the Venetian Hotel. We're on the balcony. We're looking down at your stage.
Isn't it great?
This is a wonderful.
Isn't that a nice showroom?
This is great.
I love it.
You started out as a young girl dancing, right?
Well, you know, my mom had a dance studio in Tennessee, and she moved out here to become a dancer in the Folies Bergère. And that's how this whole thing began, because she had a dream of being on stage here in Las Vegas. And I grew up here, went to school here, studied magic here, and here I am today with my own show.
When did the magic thing hit you?
When I was about 13, I had a dream that I was performing magic on stage. And I think it's because my family were entertainers, and I would see so many shows with magicians on it. And I loved magic. And I think it was a subliminal thing. I just went to sleep and dreamt about being a magician. And my mom thought it was the greatest idea. I told her the next day, and she said, you know, that is so great. If you would take your dancing and put the magic together, you would have something really unique. So we went off and studied magic together and worked very hard, and she produced the first 8 shows that I did. So we worked together for 8 years, doing 2 shows a night, 6 nights a week. She was the producer of my show, and I was the magician. I had never seen a lady magician before. All my role models were dancers or singers. I loved Anne Margaret, Cher, Charo. You know, and so I really didn't have a role model as a lady magician. So it was very difficult in the beginning, and I would watch all the males and try to be like them, but you can't when you're a woman. So it took a while for me to find what my niche was with my show. I was very dramatic in the beginning, and I didn't speak much in my act, and I, you know, tried to come out and be very mysterious. And I feel like sometimes the women in the audience would feel a little uncomfortable. And I started drawing the people in more when I started talking. But that was the hardest thing for me to do, because I thought, well, once I open my mouth, I'm going to stick my foot right in there and people are going to hate me. And it was the exact opposite. Even if I, you know, messed up a little bit or whatever happened when I was talking, the people got closer to me and more warm, and it just worked out perfectly.
Do you have last words to say to your wife?
No, because I'm divorced.
Ooh, okay. That was touching.
We'll have right, more from Melinda
more
after this.
1, 2.
Now we return to the Venetian and the world's hottest magic show, starring Melinda, the First Lady of Magic.
You know what's really great about your show? We're actually designing it for kids.
Yeah.
Kids are excited to come and see you.
Yes. The kids love the show, and I love kids, and I'm having so much fun with them. So I'm so glad to see that Las Vegas is having more of a family-style audience.
You actually bring a child on stage, right?
Yes, I bring a little girl up on stage and I do some fun things with her. When I put the car illusion in, I bring a whole bunch of kids up on stage, or adults, depending. This show is a family show, and whether, you know, any age can watch the show.
I'm all cut up. Jacqueline, can you touch my hand again?
I've never seen Sharon.
Still real?
Yes.
How about my toes? Are they still real?
What do you think?
Yes. All right, step aside and watch this. I think they call this a split personality.
All magicians have trademarks.
Right.
What is your trademark illusion?
My trademark illusion, I have a few of them. One is the drill, which is a death-defying drill. Yes, Andre Cole designed this illusion for me. It's a very, very dramatic, scary illusion. No one else is doing this illusion. Well, I always pray. I pray before the show starts, and we always pray that everything goes good and everybody's safe and, you know, that there's no injuries. Because in a magic show, there's a lot of danger around. There's a lot of things, even just in on a theater, on a stage, theatrical lighting or sets or anything that's rigged up above your head. You always want everything to be as safe as it can be.
And it could be. It's dangerous. There's a lot of
very dangerous
things happening.
Yes,
and things
it
could
is.
Happen.
And behind the scenes and things moving around, and it's very fast paced. And you know, I do like 15 costume changes, and there's all these things happening all at one time. But the whole trick of the show is to make it look like it's smooth and like it's effortless and that it's just really just happening. Great team. It's not just me. I have great dancers. I have a wonderful juggler, Anthony Gatto, and I have a whole crew of people that work behind the scenes that just, you know, have pushed so hard to make this whole thing work. Plus my brother David, who's the producer of the show.
Yeah, David.
So yeah. So I feel so great about the show. So you have to come. Please come see.
Melinda, thank you so much.
Thank you so
great
much,
to see you
Tony.
Again.
It's so thank nice you. To see you. Thank you for having me on.
That's great.
That's great.
Oh, my God. I have to be at the Hilton. I'm late. What am I going to do?
Don't worry about it. I can fix that. Here we go. Come see me at the Venetian.